Furthermore, God meets all the needs of all the beings. Thanks to His infinite mercy and compassion, we live in this world in peace and happiness. God created the sun so that we can be warm. It is also God who created numerous foods for us to take nourishment from. For example, one of these is vegetables. Fruits are also God's blessings. In addition, God creates many other blessings for us. God created the rain so that we can have fresh water to drink. Water is vital for us because man can only survive without water for a few days. Water has a particular taste, which is easy to drink. God states in the Quran that He created the water that we drink particularly for us. Have you thought about the water that you drink? Is it you who sent it down from the clouds, or are we the sender? If we wished, we could have made it bitter, so will you not give thanks? God created fresh water for us to drink. The salty water of the seas is convenient for fish and other sea creatures. These creatures are created with the organs and systems necessary to live in salty waters. God placed an immune system into our bodies to protect us against microbes. Without this system, we could die of a simple microbe that causes colds. God makes our hearts beat unceasingly. The heart continuously pumps blood.
Red blood cells in the blood enable us to take oxygen.
God created eyes to see. Ears to hear. A nose to smell. And a tongue to taste foods. These are only a few of the blessings God has given us. We cannot count the blessings God gives us. In a verse, God, who is very compassionate and merciful, addresses us as follows. He has given you everything you have asked Him for. If you tried to number God's blessings, you could never count them. Thank you. In return for his blessings, we should love God and be grateful to him. That is, we should thank him. Dear children, never forget this fact. It is God who protects and nourishes you, your mother, your father, all people, and all beings. We are all in need of God, and we must be grateful to him. Being honest and sincere. God is the all-powerful. He hears every word we utter and sees each act we do. He is aware of every thought that crosses our minds. Therefore, it is not possible for a person to hide anything from him. This fact is related in the Quran as follows. Say, whether you conceal what is in your breasts or make it known, God knows it. He knows what is in the heavens and what is on earth. God has power over all things. This being the case, we should always be honest and sincere towards God. We should live in the way that He demands us to. God has forbidden people to be disdainful, snobbish, dishonest, and arrogant. The moral qualities that God is pleased with are honesty, submission, modesty, benevolence, compassion, and justice. We too should comply with these qualities throughout our lives to please God. In other words, we should think and act in the way He teaches us. He addresses us in the Quran as follows. Humanity, remember God's blessing to you. Is there any creator other than God providing for you from heaven and earth? There is no deity but Him.